registry, I started with the clinic as a board member in 1983. And I was on the board until 1990, when I became the executive director. Back then we had about 45 employees. Now we have about 320 or so. We were very small. I think we had 7 doctors. Now we have 50 medical providers. So obviously the change has been growth.
It's grown like crazy. Our original, what we call our original site at 1032, the Chavez Health Center. We've been there since 1971, but up until 1997, all of our services were located in just that one facility. We've really expanded since then. And we bought the Greenfield building, the building where we are. We bought this building in 1997 and moved our WIC program here, our environmental health program here, our administrative offices here, and AmeriCorps is located here also. In 2007, we opened our Parkway clinic. And so now we have 2 major health centers in Milwaukee, along with our administration building. Just, 2 years ago, we started a very small clinic in partnership with the United Community Center, which is a senior center clinic.
And then last year we opened up our Waukesha,
which is our first experience being in a community outside of Milwaukee. So we're really excited to watch that clinic grow and adapt our services out there to the needs of the people from Waukesha.
As the clinic expanded, the patient population became more diverse.
In 1985 or so, I may have the dates off a little bit, I got a call from the state and said, we are starting a new program. We're participating with the federal government in this relocation program of these folks from Laos called Hmong. And we want to know if you will see them. They all need a physical, and some will probably likely stay and be your patients. And we thought, okay, do you have anything? What do we know about them? Do you have materials? And they said, well, they don't really have a written language. You'll have to kind of figure it out. And we kind of learned how to work with them as they kind of learned how to work with us. And so the huge demographic that changed in the 80s was the beginning of a Hmong community, kind of layered into that Hispanic community that it is now. The biggest change since I was here has certainly been the, old Polish to Mexican to Puerto Rican, and then some Central and South American population, smaller communities, then Hmong, and now some percentage of African American. So it's a dynamic community.
But we're still 85% Hispanic, so that's still our main population.
16th Street's dedication to public health was embodied in the Department of Environmental Health.
My name is Ben Gramling. I'm the Director of Environmental Health here at the 16th Street Community Health Center in Milwaukee. And I've been working here in the department since 2001. So I just entered my 13th year on staff here in the department. Well, the department was started back in the mid-1990s. It grew out of more of an organic evolution of understanding among the agency's leaders regarding our potential role in addressing the physical and environmental factors that exist on Milwaukee's south side that were contributing to the kinds of problems that our medical providers were seeing on a very regular basis in the clinic setting. What the department really started from were a couple of key individuals who had the idea that we could work to better understand and document those conditions and then start to develop programming. So it really started from nothing. Our childhood lead poisoning prevention program focuses on three major responsibilities. One, making sure that children are being screened for lead poisoning at appropriate points in time. And we're fortunate that our agency as a whole, including our clinical staff, really understand the need to screen children. The second responsibility is to then respond to that screening by deploying bilingual outreach staff into the communities to work with families in the environments where exposure to environmental lead is taking place. And so getting into the homes and working with families there so that we can point, quite literally, point out where that exposure may be taking place, and to demonstrate the relatively low cost, low effort steps that they can take to at least reduce exposure. The third responsibility has historically been for us to work with the Milwaukee Health Department and other partners to, in a more permanent fashion, abate residential properties of lead-based paint. When the program was first getting going, the rates of lead poisoning were upwards of 38, 39, or 40% of kids who were tested showing elevated blood lead levels. We've been able to bring that prevalence rate down to closer to 2%. Which is tremendous. What you see in Milwaukee today is a near south side that in some respects has a lot of promise, has a lot of hope for a future of renewal, and we're seeing that renewal take place before our eyes. Thank you.